So if you've seen my previous videos, you know I'm all in for automation. Today's tool is also an automation tool. Today's product showcase can help you automate your entire email marketing flow, of course with some exceptions when it comes to your content. Today's tool is called Encharge.io, and it's a great alternative to ActiveCampaign. I will go through the different aspects of Encharge.io in this video. When I first started in the onboarding process, it was fairly easy. I had three action steps. The first step was to import all of my contacts. Here I could choose either an Excel file or a CSV file. So you have to really export all of your contacts from the previous tool that you're using if you have contacts. I would love for them to make an integration to MailChimp or ActiveCampaign. By doing this, I can literally with one click, maybe enter an API key or something like that. Then I can basically import all of my contact very easily. I would love to see them develop that in the future. The next step is integration step. Here, I was a bit disappointed, I must say. They had a few integrations, and when I compare to ActiveCampaign, they have more than 850 native integrations. Of course, Encharge has an integration to Zapier. However, you have to be aware that it comes at an extra cost because you need a subscription using Zapier as well. But it opens up more than 3,000 different integrations. But without further ado, let's dive in and create the first flow in Encharge.io. So when you're through the onboarding process, depending on if you have imported contacts or not, this is the first step you see. I haven't imported any contacts and I haven't made the flow yet. So let's dive in and create the first flow. As you can see here, there are a lot of different templates, which is great, whether you want churn prevention, you want to nurture your leads, for instance, you want to make email broadcasts, onboarding, and so on. I'm just going to start completely blank. So as you can see out here, we have a lot of different things to work with. Overall, first, we need a trigger. Then we can make a filter if we want to. And then what's going to happen based on this trigger. So let's say we are going to make a form submitted. When I have added my form submitted, I can choose where this form has been submitted, whether it's Elementor in WordPress, BotStar, which is a chatbot system, or something third. I'm just going to choose Elementor. You can see now that there is a webhook URL. This one I need to put into my Elementor, and then now it's ready. This is my trigger. Now let's go down and take a look at actions. What do we want to do when this form is submitted? First of all, I want to add a tag, and then I make a connection. So when this form is submitted, add the tag, contact me. This I can use for statistics in metrics and so on. Now I want to send them an email based on this. I'll just move it down here. It's a little bit easier. Okay. This email is either I can choose an email I have set up in the email flow. I'll show that in a minute. Or I can just create a new one, which is also in the email flow here. And then I'm going to make a connection again, send email. So now every time this form is submitted, it's going to add a tag, contact me, and then it's going to send an email. This is a very simple flow, but a cool thing about this is that now I have all of my leads collected within Encharge.io, so in the future I can easily work with them. I can also add a lead score if I want that, and let's say that it's going to increase by 10 if they sign up via this form, like this. Let's just move it a little bit down, make an arrow, and then say undelivered. So my entire flow now is that they submit the form on my website. I add the tag, contact me. I send an email to them, and then I increase the lead score by 10 if the email is sent successfully. This is one type of flow. And as you can see, it's very easy. I can easily zoom in and out if that's what I want to do. I can easily move it around, and it works very well. Out here, we have all of our filters, actions, and triggers. And of course, the more integrations they build in, the more actions and triggers are possible. If you want to add a filter, let's say that they need to book a meeting, then of course you need to connect your Calendly account. And when you have connected that, then they can easily set this as a filter saying that if they book a meeting, we'll increase the lead score by even more. So let's say then we're going to increase the lead score by 50. The reason why is that if they book a meeting, then it's because they really want to talk. And of course, I can just keep on building and building. And you can see how easy it is. That's a huge benefit from Encharge.io. This is the people section, and I'm just gonna add a person. You can see I can add a lot of different elements, and the reason why is because we can use these elements in our flows. So we can say all people from Denmark or from England, they need to have this specific email every Tuesday, for instance. Or we can say all people with this title need to see this view. This is very basic. Of course, you can make it a lot more advanced, but in here you will have all of your people, and you always have this plus down here where you can add a segment, add a folder, custom field, import spreadsheet. It's fairly simple. I'm not gonna dive so much into it. You have a view. Over here you can see the activity. Here you can see the information. You can delete, edit, add a tag. For instance, if I add the tag contact me. The next tab is their broadcast tab. In here you can send, as it says, product updates, important news, or other one-off emails that you want to send. This is great if you just want to send something out quickly and very simple. So I'm just going to choose all people. As you've seen it before, I save and close. Now the email is ready, I choose it. Continue to A/B test, because this is cool. You can really test these different things out and test out what version works best. And it will automatically tell you what works best. And here you can choose the distribution. And down here we set the different variations. Here we can choose between different subjects, from information. So it's minor things right now. Of course, we can also here control the different emails if I had added more emails. So let's just disable this for now and continue to review. Here you can choose to either schedule it or send the broadcast right now. And if I send it, then it's going to send out the emails. In the emails tab, we can see all the emails that we have created. We can easily edit them, add new ones, delete, and then we can see some short information about it, whether how many it has delivered, how many has opened, clicked, and unsubscribed by receiving this email. This is great statistics to see whether you need to engage more with your visitors or your users to make them click more on your emails, or if you don't get any opens, then maybe you need to work on your subject. The last tab is the metrics tab. This, I don't have any data, but in here you can see basically all the email data that I just showed you. You can just see it for all of your emails. You can save it as a PDF if that's what you feel for. But overall, that is the interface of Encharge.io and what's possible. As you can see, it's fairly simple, but they're adding features all the time, and I'm gonna dive into that now. When we take a look at their pricing structure, compared to ActiveCampaign, I must say that I'm a little disappointed here too. ActiveCampaign has more than 850 native integration, whereas Encharge.io has very much less. They have around 50, a little bit more. But when I compare the pricing, it's almost similar. Both of the plans that Encharge.io offers are depending on the amount of subscribers and the plan you choose. The more subscribers, the more expensive it becomes. I know that running an email marketing software can be expensive for Encharge.io, but I feel until they have more native integrations that they should lower their price, because right now ActiveCampaign is a better choice when you compare on both features and price-wise. So if we take a look at their competitors, there are of course ActiveCampaign, which I have talked some about. ActiveCampaign is just a further better tool right now than Encharge.io. I'm not saying that Encharge.io can't reach ActiveCampaign. They definitely have the possibility to do so. They just need to develop more integrations and optimize their flow module, because the better that becomes, the better they become compared to ActiveCampaign. Another competitor to Encharge.io is called Mautic. I haven't personally used them, so I can't talk about them. But based on their features, they are an alternative if you want to see what's out there elsewhere. When we take a look at the future for Encharge.io, it's actually very exciting. They're focusing on making a landing page builder. So with a landing page builder, they might actually be able to separate themselves from ActiveCampaign. Furthermore, it's a great way for you to easily test out an idea you have. Let's say that you want to test out a product that you have had this idea for a long time. Then via the landing page builder, you can very fast build a landing page, set it up for a list, and then set up an automation for this list within Encharge.io, and then you have maybe done it with an hour or two, and then you have a way that you can test all of your ideas so fast. I think it's such a great idea from Encharge.io, and I'm personally very excited to see how it turns out. Furthermore, they're going to work more on their flow module and optimize all the things around that. And of course, they're going to add more integrations. I'm very happy to see this. In the near future, they're working on PayPal and MailChimp, but when we look further out, there are a lot of exciting integrations that just need to come, because it's going to be exciting to use and to see how it works, because native integrations are just cheaper for us users to use, and it works better because it's a native integration. So that's my take on Encharge.io, a great alternative to ActiveCampaign. They maybe need to work a little on their pricing structure, but with the landing page builder coming up, they have an exciting future within. I hope that you liked the video, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions to Encharge.io, or you want that I review other products, please leave a comment down below. Thank you so much for watching. Let's catch up on the next one.